GSLP's electoral campaign will centre around the fact that a vote for its candidate is the only one that will result in a minister and not just a parliamentarian. At this morning's news conference, where the party presented Albert Isola, the chief minister said the electorate needed to give the government the tools it needed to deliver its manifesto commitments and more. The mood is already one of campaigning. Albert Isola said it was all about policy, philosophy and change. He added he looked forward to delivering the government's programme and to being able to make an impact on working people's lives, even if the circumstances would not have been of anyone's choosing.
I wish I wasn't here. I wish there wasn't a by-election. I wish Charles Brisson was still with us. He was a man of enormous dignity, honesty and integrity, and Gibraltar will certainly miss him. But there's a responsibility now in the party to move on and to do what Charles would have wanted us to do, which is to win his seat back. I've had a lot of people coming up to me asking me, why didn't you think about doing it? Why didn't you do it? And there's just been a momentum that's built up. I've chatted to my family and the people that are close to me, my children, my wife, my mother, my brothers, my close friends, and I've had nothing but complete support. So I thought, well, I'm at an age now where I can. When I left politics in 2000, I had four children under the age of 10. I had a business to look after. It was a very, very difficult and challenging time to juggle politics at that stage. I'm far better prepared now to do that. My eldest is 22, my youngest is 14, so that part of their process is through, and I've done that, which is, I think, what everyone has an obligation to look after your kids and do the best you can with them. And the timing just thought, well, why not give it a go? So I threw my name in the hat.
Do you think that will work against you, the fact that you did leave the party when in opposition?
I've got to tell you, I've never left. I stopped going, if you want to call it that. But I've always been involved. I've always been in touch. I haven't been on the executive since 2000. I haven't been actively involved in politics since 2000. And it was it's a bit overwhelming, to be honest with you, because last night at the annual general meeting, I was just blown away by the warmth, the response. When people talk about the GSLP family, unless you touch it, you don't know what they're talking about. And for me, going back last night was the easiest thing I've done in my life, and it was quite emotional. I worked with a number of people who were no longer with us, not just Charles, but obviously Joshua, Robert, who were wonderful people to work with. So it was a very emotional night, but a very satisfying one. And the response I got, to have a standing ovation on my first one back, was really quite special for me, and I was thrilled, absolutely thrilled.
At this morning's news conference, the Chief Minister had made clear that Albert Isola would be given a portfolio. I asked Mr. Isola to confirm whether he agreed that this was at the heart of the campaign.
Well, it's a fundamental point, isn't it? It's a fundamental question. If you vote for Nick Cruz, who's a great guy and a friend of mine, or you vote for Marlene, who I don't know, but obviously look forward to meeting, or any other independent that stands, you could argue it was a wasted vote to the extent that that person is simply going to be criticising, opposing, issuing press releases and complaining about what we're doing. There's only one person that is actually able to do anything to help the people, to put Gibraltar first, to put the campaign and the change that's been promised in motion. So I have an advantage in that sense, that people will vote for me if they want something to be done. If they want to have another voice in the opposition, then I obviously won't be the choice for that person. So, yeah, that will be at the heart of the campaign.